Hello students, today I'm going to discuss the chapter solution that is most important and repeated questions of NEET exams. So look at the first question. Which of the following colligative property can provide molar mass of proteins or polymers or collides with greatest precision? Which means among four colligative properties, which colligative property can give molar mass of protein or polymer or collide with the greatest precision, which means with not much difference. So here there are osmotic pressure, elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point, and relative lowering of vapor pressure. We know that these four are the colligative properties. So among these we can use, like if you consider these compounds like proteins or polymers or collides, these are generally covalent compounds. These are covalent compounds. So if you consider any covalent compounds by measuring osmotic pressure, by measuring osmotic pressure of their solution, the molecular weight or molar mass can be determined easily. So that for question number one, option A is correct. Then for question number two, the beans are cooked earlier in pressure cookers because, so I think you are familiar with this question, because amma adige madavaga nodirthivi, so cooker li modalegene beans na avaru en maadtare pressure cooker li ittu besirtare. So what's the reason? So it's very easy. The beans are cooked earlier in pressure cooker because the boiling point increase with increase in pressure. So if we increase the boiling point, which increases the pressure. So that for question number two is also option A. Let me go for question number three. Molarity of liquid HCl if density of the solution is 1.17 gram per cubic centimeter is. So here, so first we will write the given 1 cc of HCl solution containing or which contains 1.17 gram of HCl. Therefore, 1000 cc, 1000 cc of HCl solution contains. So we can do the cross multiplication, 1.17 into 1000 divided by 1, which gives almost 1170 gram of HCl. Therefore, 36.5 gram of HCl in 1000 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 molar, or which gives 1 molar solution. So what about 1170 gram of HCl in 1000 cubic centimeter? Again, we'll make a cross multiplication, 1170 into 1 divided by 36.5, which gives 32.05 molar. So that for question number three, it's option A, 32.05 molar. Question number four. A pure water can be obtained from sea water by. So this question is, it's the case of reverse osmosis, that is known as, so desalination of water. So for question number four, it's the case of reverse osmosis. And the process is known as pure water can be obtained from sea water, and the process is desalination of sea water. So that for question number 4, it's option C, reverse osmosis. Question number 5. A solution containing components A and B follows Raoult's law. Then what are the options given? AB attraction forces is greater than AA and BB. AB attraction force is less than AA and BB. AB attraction force remains same as AA and BB. Volume of solution is different from sum of volume of solute and solvent. So this question is very simple. If a solution obeys Raoult's law, when these interactions remains same, which means the interaction between A and B, which must be equal to interaction between A and A, or interaction between B and B. So that for question number 5, it's option C. AB interaction or attraction force remains same as AA interaction and BB interaction. Question number 6. V liters of solution contains M2 gram of non-volatile solute of molecular mass M2. Which of the following can be used to calculate the molecular mass of solute in terms of osmotic pressure? So we'll use the formula to find out osmotic pressure. That is pi equals N divided by V into RT. And we know that N means number of moles. How can we find out number of moles? It is the ratio of mass divided by molar mass. So in this problem, I have considered W2 and M2. And in general, which is W by capital M, mass divided by molar mass. So that can we substitute this value of N in this formula? We'll get W2 divided by M2 into RT divided by V. So that on rearranging the formula, we can write M2 is equal to W2 divided by V RT divided by pi. That is option B. So here they have mentioned M2, small M2. So to avoid confusion, I'm using W2. So both are same. So for question number 6, it's option B. Let me go for question number 7. 1 mole and 2.5 liter NaOH solution mixed with another 0.5 molar and 3 liters of NaOH solution. Then find out molarity of the resultant solution. So here, first, we can calculate the total number of equivalents. Total number of equivalents. How can we calculate this total number of equivalents? It's very simple. Here they have given 2.5 liter and 1 molar solution. So, and 0.5 molar solution with 3 liter. So if you take the sum of product of molarity and volume, that is M1V1 plus M2V2 gives the final or total number of equivalents. So on solving, we will get 4. Then we can use the molarity formula. That is molarity is 4 divided by 3 plus 2.5, that is 3 liters and 2.5 liters. So volume of solution in liter is 4 by 5.5, which gives 0.73. So that the answer for question number 7 is option C, 0.73 molar solution. Then question number 8. Formation of a solution from two components can be considered as the pure solvent, separated solvent molecules, delta H1, pure solute, separated solute molecules, delta H2. Separated solvent and solute molecules, solution, that is delta H3. They have given the change in enthalpy for individual type of solvent and solute as well as solution. Then solution so formed will be ideal if. So they are the given options, delta H solutions they have given. So here, if you consider any ideal solution, for any ideal solution, delta H solution, which means change in the enthalpy of an entire solution is the sum of enthalpy change of individual component, like delta H1 plus delta H2 plus delta H3 plus delta Hn. So that the right answer for question number 8 is option D. Delta H solution is equal to delta H1 plus delta H2 plus delta H3. So let me go for the next question, question number 9. Camphor is often used in molecular mass determination because. So it's a very interested question. So here, camphor is often used in molecular mass determination because it's used in the determination of molecular mass because of its high cryoscopic constant. So if you don't know the value of cryoscopic constant of camphor, I will write it here. Cryoscopic constant of camphor, which is very high, that is of 37.7. So due to its high cryoscopic constant of 37.7, this camphor is used to determine molecular mass. So that for question number 9, it's option C. It is highly volatile, you know that, because it undergoes sublimation. It is conversion from solid state directly to the gaseous state, that is vapor state. And this method in which camphor is used to determine the molecular mass is generally known as Raschke's camphor method. Raschke's camphor method for the estimation of molecular mass by using camphor. So you can Google it. You will get the more information about Raschke's camphor method to the estimation of molecular mass. Now, question number 10. The vapor pressure of two liquids P and Q are 80 and 60 torr respectively. Then the total vapor pressure of the solution obtained by mixing 3 mole of P and 2 mole of Q would be. This question is little much difficult. Here, if you consider N of P, which is equal to 3, that is number of moles of P. Similarly, number of moles of Q, which is given as 2. Similarly, P naught of P, partial pressure, which is of 80 torr. And for Q, P naught Q, which is given as 60 torr, and X of P, which is 3 by 5. X is nothing but a mole fraction. Similarly, X of Q, which is 2 by 5. And pressure of P, we can calculate the pressure by the product of mole fraction and partial pressure, 3 by 5 into 80. Similarly, P of Q is equal to 2 by 5 into 60. So here, P of P, you will get 48 torr. Similarly, P of Q will get 24 torr. Then we can calculate P total. So how can we calculate P total? It's the sum of P, pressure of P as well as pressure of Q, that is individual liquids. P of P plus P of Q. What is P of P? It is 48 and P of Q is 24, which is equal to 72 torr. That is option B. So it's a little bit difficult, which means we have to write all those given terms first, then we can find out the pressure, that is total pressure of the mixture. Question number 11. The mole fraction of the solute in 1 molar aqueous solution is. So here we have to find out mole fraction of solute. First we have to write the formula. Mole fraction of a solute is equal to number of moles of solute to that of total number of moles of the solution. That is nothing but number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. So here number of moles of solute they have given is 1 molar. So that 1 divided by 1. Solvent, 1 molar means we are going to use 1000 ml of water, 1 liter of water. And what's the molar mass of water? It's 18. So which gives 0.018 on solving. So which gives 0.018. Then what may be the mole fraction of solvent? We can also find out the mole fraction of solvent without going through this complete formula, because we know that mole fraction of a solution, any solution, is the sum of mole fraction of solute and mole fraction of solvent. And the product of, sum of mole fraction of individual component present in a mixture must be equal to 1. So that 1 minus 0.018, which gives mole fraction of solvent. Question number 12. The surface tension of which of the following liquid is maximum? So here they have given benzene, C6H6, water molecule, H2O. Then methanol, CH3OH, and ethanol, C2H5OH. So it's very easiest question. The surface tension of water is maximum among all these other options or other molecule. And the reason is it is due to the formation of hydrogen bonding. So we can expect hydrogen bonding in water, but not with this molecule. And to expect a hydrogen bonding, hydrogen must be directly attached to either any of these three highly electronegative elements, either with fluorine or with oxygen or with nitrogen. Then question number 13, a solution of urea boils at 100.18 degrees Celsius at the atmospheric pressure. If Kf and Kb for water are 1.86 and 0.512 Kelvin kg per mole respectively, the above solution will freeze at, and they have given the molar mass of urea, so that is 56 gram per mole. So let me consider. So here, delta Tb they have given is, we have to calculate the delta Tb, that is 100.18 minus 100, which gives us 0.18. Then we can take the ratio delta Tb divided by delta Tf, which gives Kbm divided by Kfm. So m here is common, so that we can take Kb by Kf. And delta Tb is 0.18, what we have calculated, and delta Tf, you can write it as it is. Then Kb value they have given is 0.512, and Kf value they have given is 1.86. So that after simplifying, you will get the value of delta Tf, that is 0.654. then we can calculate TF, because they are asked to find out TF of a solution. So that TF is equal to 0.654 degree Celsius, which is equal to -0.0654 degree Celsius. So it is option C, -0.654 degree Celsius. Now go for the next one, question number 14. During osmosis, a flow of water through a semi-permeable membrane is. So we know that during osmosis, a flow of water through a semi-permeable membrane is from solution having lower concentration only. That is option B. So for question number 14, it's option B, from solution having lower concentration only. Go for question number 15, which is a solution containing 10 gram per dm cube of urea having the molecular mass 60 gram per mole is isotonic with a 5% solution of a non-volatile solute. Then the molecular mass of this non-volatile solute is, can calculate the molecular mass by using the formula. For isotonic solution, they have mentioned for isotonic solution. So here they have mentioned isotonic solution. For isotonic solution, W divided by M1 V1 is equal to W2 divided by M2 V2. W1 they have given is 10 gram. Then M1, it is 60 gram molecular mass. Then volume, that is 1000. Then W2, they have given 5%, which means 5 gram. Then M2, we have to calculate into. So V2 is 100. Now we can rearrange the formula to find out M2. And on solving, you will get the answer 300 gram per mole. That is option D. 300 gram per mole. Then question number 16. 1 gram of a non-electrolyte solution or solute, molar mass 250 gram per mole, was dissolved in 51.2 gram of benzene. If the freezing point depression constant Kf of benzene is 5.12 Kelvin kg per mole, the freezing point of benzene will be lowered by. We can apply the formula here. Delta T is equal to 1000 into Kf into W divided by capital W into M. So substitute those given values, like 1000 Kf value they have given is 5.12 and mass they have given is 1. Then molar mass given is 250 gram per mole and mass of solute, that is 51.2 gram of benzene. And on solving this, we'll get 0.4 Kelvin, that is option C. Question number 16 is option C, 0.4 Kelvin. Question number 17. A solution of acetone in ethanol behaves like a near ideal solution, obeys Raoult's law, shows a negative deviation from Raoult's law, and shows a positive deviation from Raoult's law. Then which option is the correct one? So here option C, that shows a negative deviation from Raoult's law. So we have given the examples that which solution shows positive deviation and negative deviation from the Raoult's law. So here acetone and chloroform develops hydrogen bonding between them. we can expect a hydrogen bonding. So due to increase in interacting or interactive force, they show negative deviation from Raoult's law. So that for question number C, 17, it's option C. Question number 18. A 0.5 molar aqueous solution of a weak acid HX is 20% ionized if KF for water is 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. The lowering in freezing point of the solution is. So here we can apply formula. First, we can write the dissociation reaction. HX on dissociation gives H plus plus X minus. So dissociation, that is 1 minus alpha, and for H plus and X minus, you can write alpha. Alpha represents that the dissociation constant. Then total moles is equal to 1 plus alpha. So I is equal to 1 plus alpha, which is equal to 1 plus 0.2. Then delta TF, which is equal to I into KF into M, that is 1.2 value of I, and KF they have given is 1.86 and the mass 0.5 molar, that is molality. Then we'll get 1.116 Kelvin. So which is almost nearest to that of 1.12 Kelvin. That is option C, 1.12 Kelvin. Look at the question number 19. What is the OH minus ion in the final solution prepared by mixing 20 ml of 0.05 molar HCl with 30 ml of 0.10 mole of barium hydroxide, BaOH twice. Let me consider the concentration of OH minus ion. It is MbVb minus MaVa divided by Va plus Vb. That is total volume of the solution. So here we can substitute. The molarity of component B is 0.1 and its volume will be 30. And molarity of component A is 20 and its volume is 20 and its molarity is 0.05. And total volume of the solution is 30 plus 20, which gives 50. And on simplifying, you will get 3 minus 1 divided by 50. Then, so 2 by 50, which is equal to 0.04. That is option B. Then question number 20. 25.3 gram sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3, is dissolved in enough water to make 250 ml of solution. If sodium carbonate dissociates completely, molar concentration of sodium ion and carbonate ions are respectively. And they have given the molar mass of sodium carbonate, that is 106 gram per mole. So here first we can find out molarity. Weight divided by molar mass into 1000 divided by volume in ml. Or else we can use the standard molarity formula, number of moles of solute present in volume of solution, is 1 liter. Then we can substitute those values. 25.3 is the mass, then 106 they have given the molar mass, into 1000 divided by 250 ml they have given, so that we can get the molarity 0.955 mole per liter of sodium carbonate Na2CO3. Then they have given one sentence like, if sodium carbonate dissociates completely, let me consider a reaction that gives dissociation of sodium carbonate. Na2CO3 and dissociation gives 2Na++CO3 to the power 2 minus. How many Na2 or Na plus ions are there? There are 2 Na plus ions are there. Then what's the molarity of Na plus ion? That is 0.955 mole. So therefore, Na plus concentration, which is equal to 2 into 0.955, which gives 1.910 molar, which is the concentration of Na plus ion, that is 1.910. Then what is the concentration of CO3 to the power 2 minus? So it is present in 1 unit. So that 1 into 0.955, which gives the same value, 0.955 molar. It is option C. For question number 20, it's option C. 1.910 molar and 0.955 molar. Then we go to the next question number 21. An aqueous solution is 1.00 molar in Ki, that is potassium iodide. Which change will cause the vapor pressure of the solution of increase? Addition of water, addition of NaCl, addition of Na2SO4, addition of 100 molar potassium iodide. So here, according to Raoult's law, we have a formula like PS is equal to P of XA. That XA that represents the mole fraction of solvent. Then XP represents the mole fraction of solute. Then, and on addition of water, the mole fraction of water in solution increases. That is, mole fraction of solvent is increases. So that vapor pressure of the solution is also increases. Hence, for question number 21, it's option A. 22. A solution of sucrose having the molar mass 342 gram per mole has been prepared by dissolving 68.5 gram of sucrose in 1000 gram of water. The freezing point of the solution obtained will be. So I have given the Kf for water is 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. So let me consider delta Tf. We have a formula and I will write the substitution directly. 68.5 into 1000 divided by the molecular mass is 342 into 1000 into the Kf value they have given is 1.86. Now, on solving this, you will get the value of delta F as 0.372. Then freezing point of the solution is 0 degrees Celsius minus 0.372, which gives minus 0.372 degrees Celsius. That is option B. Minus 0.372 degrees Celsius. Then we'll go for question number 23. Of the following 0.1 molar aqueous solutions, which one will exhibit the largest freezing point depression? So options are like KCl, C6H12O6, Al2SO4 thrice, and K2SO4. Let me consider delta. Tf is equal to KfMi. Therefore, delta Tf is directly proportional to Mi. If you remove the constant Kf, delta Tf is directly proportional to M and I. So M is same. So the deciding factor is I, because they have mentioned here of the following 0.1 molar aqueous solution, so that the molality of all these solution is same, so that delta TF depends only on the factor I. So that can we calculate I value. So we'll calculate the value of I, and I will just write the value of I like Al2SO4 thrice is having the I value 5, which is greater than K2SO4, which is having the I value 3, greater than KCl, which is having 2, then C6H12O6, that is having 1. So here, okay, I will write it here. How to calculate that is I value. So if you take an example of Al2SO4 thrice, I will explain for one molecule, which is on dissociation gives Al3 plus plus SO4 2 minus. So to balance the positive and negative charge, we have to add 2 Al3 plus and 3 SO4 2 minus. Then the product will be neutral. How many ions included after dissociation? That is 5. So for K2SO4, it's 3, KCl, it's 2, and C6H12O6, it is 1. So which is having the highest I value here? That is Al2SO4 thrice. So that delta F is directly proportional to I, and aluminium sulfate is having the maximum I value of 5. So that for question number 23, it's option C. Then 24, the boiling point of 6.2 mole per kg solution of X in water is greater than equimolar at solution of Y in water. Which of the following statements is true in this case? So option is X is undergoing dissociation in water. Molecular mass of X is greater than molecular mass of Y. Molecular mass of X is less than that of Y. Y is undergoing dissociation in water while X undergoes no change. So what may be the correct option for this? Okay, let me consider delta TB. That is KBIM, which is similar to the previous question. In that previous question, we have considered delta TF, which is equal to KFIM. For delta TB, it is KBIM. So here also, they have given all the solution is having the M is same for all these solution, that is X as well as Y. So that here also delta TB, which is directly proportional to I, which depends on the value of I. Here as a delta TB of X, which is greater than delta TB of Y. So as IX, which is greater than IY. So it means X undergoes a dissociation in the solution because it's having highest value of I dissociation constant I. Now, which is the correct option for question number 24? It's option A. X is undergoing dissociation in water. Then 25. Which one of the following electrolyte has the same value of the Van 't Hoff factor I as that of aluminium sulfate if all are 100% ionized? So it is also based on Van 't Hoff factor I. So let me consider question number 25, that is aluminium sulfate Al2SO4 thrice, which is having the value of I is 5, as we have discussed in the previous problems. Similar to aluminium sulfate, if you consider K2SO4, which is having 2K plus plus SO4 2 minus, is I value is 3. Then if you consider K4FeCN 6 times, So this is on dissociation, complete dissociation. This is the 4K++ FeCN6 to the power 4 minus. Similar. So here the I value is 4 plus 1, 5. Okay, one option I've got. Then K3FeCN6. So we'll write the direct value of I. So here 3 plus and 3 minus, so that is 3 plus 1, I value is 4. Then here AlNO3 thrice, which is having Al3 plus plus 3NO3 minus. So here also the I value is 1 plus 3, that is equal to 4. So among these options, the option D, that is K4FeCN6, which is having the equal value of Van 't Hoff factor with that of aluminum sulfate. So for both the molecule, Van 't Hoff factor value is 5. Question number 26. At 100 degrees Celsius, the vapor pressure of the solution of 6.5 gram of a solute in 100 gram of water is 732 mm. If Kb value is 0.52, the boiling point of the solution will be. So let me consider. So here for question number 26, using Raoult's law, we have a formula P naught minus Ps divided by Ps, which is equal to number of moles divided by N. It is W into M divided by W into M and 2. So 760 mm of mercury minus 732 divided by, again the same 732, then which is equal to 65 into 18 divided by MP, which we have to calculate into 100. So on solving, you will get the value of MP as 30.6. Then you can calculate delta TB, which is equal to KB into mass divided by molar mass, molar T into 1000. So here on substituting 0.52 into it is 65 into 1000 divided by 100 into 30.6, you will get 1.1. So boiling point of the solution, which is 100 plus 1.1, which is equal to 101.1 degrees Celsius. That is almost equal to option B, 101 degrees Celsius. Then for question number 27, which of the following is incorrect for ideal solution? Delta H mix is equal to 0, delta U mix is equal to 0, delta P, which is equal to P absorbed minus P calculated, which is equal to 0, and delta G mix, which is equal to 0. Okay, now if you consider this question, given delta G mix, which is equal to, we have a formula, delta H mix minus T into delta S mix. The original formula is delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. We can alter like this. And which of the following is incorrect for ideal solution? For ideal solution, delta H mix is 0 mix minus T delta S, which remains as it is. So here, if delta H is equal to 0, then if delta H becomes 0, delta G mix is depends on the value of T into delta S, and the temperature remains same, then which depends on the value of delta S only. And we know that delta S mix cannot be 0 for ideal solution. So that if delta S is not equal to 0, therefore, delta G mix cannot be equal to 0. So that for question number 27, it's option D, which is an incorrect for ideal solution. So for ideal solution, delta G mix, which cannot be equal to 0. Question number 28. The Van 't Hoff factor I for a dilute aqueous solution of the strong electrolyte barium hydroxide is, so it's just a simple question. So barium hydroxide, BaOH twice, which on dissociation gives Ba2 plus plus 2OH minus. So what are the ions present? That is I is equal to 3. And if degree of dissociation is 100%, then value of I is equal to N, which is equal to 3. So that for question number 28, the correct option is D. So students, if this video is helpful for you, give like and share with your friends. And if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, that is Catalyst Chemistry Classes by KP. So please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, Catalyst Chemistry Classes KP. Thank you.